Rockets. Speaking of which, that's one of the benefits of LeBron going west to play for LA, right? We get to see him against these Golden State Warriors four times a year. This is the first time this season we're going to see these two in the regular season. What are you expecting from this first matchup?
Well, it's like a Christmas tradition now, right? LeBron and the Warriors. Look, I'm expecting all the fireworks we normally get when LeBron is dealing with that Warriors team. They are his nemesis, GA. This is the team that has kept him from, you know, brandishing a legacy that's even greater than the one he has. He's got to have that on his mind when he sees him on Christmas. But it's going to be interesting just to see what that dynamic is now that it's the Lakers and the Warriors in this matchup as opposed to the Cavaliers and the Warriors.
Yeah, you know, also, this is a dual story because if you think about the Warriors, they haven't looked like the team that has won three of the last four championships. They're still waiting to get DeMarcus Cousins into the rotation. Steph talked about the challenges mentally of trying to win it and go to five straight finals. So they're still trying to find their footing. But from the Lakers' standpoint, LeBron, this is a barometer game too, because it's going to give them a sense, win or lose, of how far away are we?
Okay.
That's really what you do when you go in a game like this. When you're the Lakers, you know, you want to see how far have our guys come? Because the record looks solid. You're happy with where you are. You know, you obviously want to be better, but you're a top four team in the West right now, trending right. Remember, they haven't had JaVale McGee here for a stretch as he's just getting out of the hospital with that pneumonia. So you want to get a sense, how far has Ball come? You know, is Kuzma, what we've seen, is that sustainable at the highest level? You know, is Ingram, has he reintegrated? And if you start to wonder if those guys are ready to take that next step, that's when now the potential of trades start possibly materializing sincerely this year. Because I think they're looking at if I'm Magic Johnson and Rob Pelinka and I'm looking at the Western Conference and I'm saying to myself, man, why not? Why? I mean, yeah, Denver's really good. I think if we could just get a little better, we can be as good as Denver. We could beat that team in a seven-game series. Like, that's how you have to feel and believe. And so I think this is going to be a big barometer for them to just get a sense of, are we closer to that championship caliber? Are we an elite-level team yet? And if not, what has to happen for us to get there?
Well, you mentioned the key to that is health. Because if you look at the Golden State Warriors, they dealt without Steph Curry, without Draymond Green, big part of the season. And then even for the Lakers, they just got Rajon Rondo back, who missed a month, Brandon Ingram back, who missed seven games. So to have everyone healthy, or for the most part healthy, in this game, it's a better way to see the barometer of where you stand. Right, Sekou?
It always is. I mean, but we have to be mindful of the fact that there are going to be injuries involved come playoff time, too. Mm-hmm. You never know who's going to be available later. For the Lakers, this is a measuring stick, not just for this season, but for the future. You have to know exactly how far away you are from what the Warriors put on the floor as a Lakers team with those young guys, those vets you have around them, and what pieces need to go where in order for you to really challenge the Warriors. If you're talking about taking that next step as an organization with LeBron as the centerpiece, you got to know where you can attack this Warriors team at. You have to know how it can be done and what kind of personnel is necessary, GA. Mm-hmm. Every opportunity to gather that intel, to me, is critical. And that's why this game is going to be huge for the Lakers.
And also, this isn't LeBron going to Miami when he's smack dab in the middle of his prime. He's still probably getting better. While his game is phenomenal, you got to assume if you're L.A., that four-year contract, that's our window. You know, we can't afford to take steps back. We got to make sure we keep pushing the envelope forward here. So I do think there's going to be a little more of a sense of urgency. That's why I think you saw Magic Johnson have the conversations he had with Luke Walton early in the season about not so much whether they were winning or losing games, but how they were playing. And so I think they understand that we have to be in championship mode now. Not so much that we have to win it, but we have to have that mindset, that mentality. We have to bring that pressure to our locker room to see if our young players can handle it. Because when expectations rise, not everybody's comfortable with that. And that's what they want to find out as well as they start really dissecting their roster and planning for the future.
Are you surprised that the Lakers, currently the fourth seed in the West this early in the season, it seems like a lot of things have gone right for them early on?
We're talking about LeBron, right?
Well, I mean, he struggled when he first went to Miami. They had their issues. You know, started off, 9-9 when his first year in Cleveland struggled a little bit. And now with the Lakers, this roster isn't necessarily, the expectations aren't what they were with those two teams.
Right. No, I mean, look, it's about time, Christmas. Mm-hmm. In each of his previous situations, it was about that time in the year where LeBron got comfortable, got a handle of what's going on, and kind of turned around. I'm not surprised that the Lakers are ahead of that curve a little bit. What I am is surprised that the West of the Western Conference is not what I thought it was going to be. I think LeBron has stepped into a Western Conference we all assumed would be this bear for the Lakers to try and conquer. San Antonio is not the San Antonio we're used to. Houston has not been the team we thought they'd be. Utah is not the team people expected them to be. And I'm not saying that's the sole reason for it, but I think the Lakers are working with a little bit better situation we anticipated because some of these other teams have not played up to the potential we saw in them.
And I think that's exactly the point I was making about they see that. Like, there's not a – when you get beyond Golden State, you're not looking at anybody saying, oh, that's a 60-win team. You know, when you win 60 in this league now, that puts you in a different category. I don't see anybody in the West winning 60 games. And so that also gives the Lakers confidence. Because, listen, make no mistake about it. When they walk on the court every night, those players play with LeBron James. They feel like they're playing with the best player in the world. That gives you confidence. That gives you a belief about we can compete with anybody. And so it's going to be fun to get a sense of where they are in relation, because you know that the Warriors are going to want to play well in that game. You know they're going to want to send a message, too, because there's a psychological battle going on. You don't want teams to feel comfortable playing you. And that's happened a little bit this year for the Warriors. Teams are having way more success against them than we've seen in years past. And so that confidence gap that they had created over the years is not quite as big, and that makes it even more of a challenge for this team as they try to win three in a row.
Certainly Christmas night. Make sure the